I keep hearing all the time that my paintings are depressive and dark. And I've often been asked about why the fuck don't I paint something positive for once? Stuff like landscapes or even portraits that are not melancholic. And of course, because of the darkness in my paintings, people often make assumptions about my own mental state, thinking that I'm some sort of a depressive train wreck. So I'd like to tackle this question and try to give it an explanation that would maybe result in a somewhat more optimistic conclusion. Is dark art depressive? The more simplistic answer would be yes. A dark painting gives you dark mood. But this is only a surface reaction to the artist's creation. It's a quick and easy reaction which we experience in the immediate moment. I, however, like to think art, for the most part, should be appreciated for its deeper effect on the psyche. It should have a subliminally layered message which prompts the viewer to start using his brain, to make him wonder and guess, to ask him to analyze what he sees, to make him experience something more than just a surface reaction to the artwork. In other words, art isn't supposed to be shallow. It's not supposed to be like the next dumb fun movie you see at the theater, which you only go to see for its freaking special effects and action. And I do acknowledge that there exists such art, and that's totally fine, but that's just not my art. I don't care about shallow, dumb fun. The only art I care about is the one that makes me think. And I come back to the beginning of the argument. Yes, at first sight, a dark artwork makes the viewer recoil, but that's just his shallow reaction, it's not what's important. What is important is the deeper, intellectually driven reaction to the painting. Is that reaction repulsive to the viewer? And the answer for me is no. Why not? Because my philosophy in life is that the world is a difficult place. Life is difficult. People suffer. They rise and fall. Some of them don't make it. And some become even stronger. Others bear the scars of their suffering. And it is those scars that define their personalities to the very end. It is precisely that suffering, those scars, that personal battle within each human being that is profoundly interesting to me. Our suffering makes us what we are. Our scars build our image. Our pain, if we survive it, makes us a better and a more powerful version of whatever we were before. Nothing makes a person grow more than suffering. Yes, people learn from the pleasant experiences in life as well, but this doesn't happen in most of the cases. It is pain that refines us, the darkness and difficulties, the evil that makes us rise up and fight. It is precisely this fight which makes up the meaning of life. And yes, each person's battle is different and unique, to each their own demons, but what is common in all of us is that we grow and learn through our encounter with darkness. I'm the kind of person who is always self-reflective and overly analytical. So I've always been trying to analyze the motives for my paintings and my overall fondness toward dark art in general. And that's the conclusion I've come to. I'm in love with the tragedy of humanity, with its eternal fight, with its desperate attempt to stand up against the world and survive. Darkness has always been more interesting to me than light and positivity. And it is this inclination that motivates my paintings. So in conclusion, to me, dark art is anything but depressive. It is actually what a person should go towards and try to face. Stand up to darkness, look into its eyes and say, "I'm not afraid, now what do you have to teach me?" Darkness is what should be the main topic of art. And it should be utilized so that through it, people can learn how to see in it their own fight, to understand and appreciate their fight, to love their fight, and to understand how to discover themselves through their fight.